now to the governor's State of the State address. In his third State of the State tonight, Governor LePage said Mainers need to take bold action to make our state a good place for business to thrive. WMTW News 8's political reporter Paul Merrill joins us now live from Augusta to tell us more about what the governor had to say tonight. Paul?
Steve, Governor LePage talked a lot about making Maine business friendly, making it a state that kids do not have to leave after college graduation just in order to find good jobs. One Republican lawmaker called tonight's address a home run, but Democrats disagree. They say these ideas were reruns of bad ideas in the past that have failed, and they hope this was the last State of the State address they have to hear from Paul LePage.
We must make some bold decisions.
Governor LePage wants to create what he calls open for business zones around the state, places where workers will not have to join unions and where businesses will get tax breaks and other incentives.
Investment capital always goes where it's welcomed and will stay where it's appreciated.
The governor also talked about improving access to cheaper energy sources and spending $2 billion to improve Maine's infrastructure. As he enters the final year of his first term, the Republican lawmaker suggested creating stricter rules for welfare recipients and railed against the Democrats' plan to expand Medicaid called MaineCare.
Adding another 100,000 people to our broken welfare system is insanity. It's unaffordable and it's fiscally irresponsible.
Lives are on the line, our economy is on the line. The governor is dead wrong on this one, and he has an opportunity to correct course, but he doubled down today about denying and delaying health care for hardworking Mainers.
Democrats who control both houses of the state legislature say they've heard all of the governor's ideas before.
And it's a sad state of affairs when the governor's economic agenda is, again, a rerun of a failed policy that he couldn't even pass in a Republican-controlled legislature.
Republican Senator Mike Thibodeau.
I think it's unfortunate that everything that the Democrats seem to hear out of the administration is something they want to criticize. I think the governor reached out several times during the State of the State to ask them, come along, let's do this together. And I guess we're calling on them as well.
The governor also talked about trying to fight Maine's growing drug problem by beefing up the Maine Drug Enforcement Agency and adding to Maine's existing drug court system. Live in Augusta, Paul Merrill, WMTW News 8. Steve?
So, Paul, how does the governor propose to pay for new drug enforcement efforts and infrastructure improvements?
Yeah, there's a lot of money behind things like that, especially a $2 billion infrastructure plan. We asked the governor's office for clarification on where this money is coming from. We have not heard back tonight. It will certainly be something people are asking over the coming days, and we may not get an answer until there's actually bills drafted up in front of the legislature up here.
All right, Paul Merrill, thank you, live in Augusta.